Hey everybody, it's Jeremy J on the path with another video. Today's video comes from a friend of mine, a friend of mine's message. And she talks about heartbreak, how she's feeling heartbroken. And she shares how certain events occurred. And she is feeling devastated and finding it very difficult even to just be in her body. Clearly, some kind of relationship of hers has ended, and she is feeling a sting from that. Why heartbreak is a good thing for you. So I would send this message to her and to any of you who are going through heartbreak or have experienced it before. I've been there. I have been in the throes of heartbreak before. About 3.5 years ago, I experienced the one and only heartbreak of my life. Certainly, I had many heartbreaks before and after that, especially in the last 3 years as I got out and dated, experienced many episodes of disconnect, and I'll call it mini heartbreak, maybe a week of mourning or retooling myself. But the major heartbreak I experienced was from the experience that many of you know on my channel as the twin flame. But I now look at that more as a catalyst experience. For 7 months. 7 months. Not 7 days. 7 months. I cried in the morning. Cried driving to work. Cried multiple times at work. Cried driving home from work. Before I pulled into my home, I'd pull into a parking lot and cry again. Then I'd go to work or go home, try to be there in that experience. 6 or 7 times a day, I was crying for 7 months. Yeah. Not just tears, the kind of tears that a sad movie might move you to. These were tears of the soul. Tears, deep, rooted tears. The kind where all you can do is lay on the floor, curl up in a ball, and just emote your body with everything you have. Just scream and yell and flood your face with tears, that kind of tears. And throughout that experience, I journaled, I talked to friends, I thought of all the good things about this person and the memories. Time was the great healer of that experience. The only thing I believe that can heal you from heartbreak is time and your own resolve to work on yourself, to learn from the experience, to honor the experience. If you are heartbroken, think about it. It means you attracted an experience with someone that was amazing. You attracted an amazing experience with someone. You did that. You put your ripple into the universe and attracted that. That's incredible. And you created many good memories in that experience. Think about that. Think about the good memories. Write them down. Because if you have heartbreak, there's much emotion and tension and dependency and attachment. And you have to take all of that and release it out through yelling, screaming, crying, getting angry. Get very angry. Write it down. Whether it's in a journal or on a piece of paper that you eventually throw away, it either is not as important as you writing it down to release and say, I release. And over time, as you do these things over and over, by the way, if you're heartbroken, you must detach fully from the experience. You must accept that experience, the time frame of that experience, has ended, is gone, is done. It's in the past. It's not coming back. It cannot come back. Time and the involvement of people and circumstances and your own progression demand that be done and left in the past, as well as who you were. Heartbreak is a good thing because the great sculptor of life, of time, has deemed you worthy for the next step in your life path, in your life growth. Chasms, remember that? Heartbreak is a chasm. And that person that broke your heart is actually taking you by the hand and lifting you over the chasm. In reality, you have broken your heart. Think about that for a second. If you're heartbroken, you have broken your heart, not this other person. Feel your heart. If you're heartbroken right now, if you're heartbroken, feel your heart in this whole area right here. Feel the pressure and the tension and the attachment, the dependency. All these things I have felt. Feel it. Allow yourself to feel it. Allow yourself to feel pain. It's okay for you to feel pain and anger and sadness and frustration and despair. You are a human being, magnificent human being with great capacity to feel. Great capacity to feel. It's part of the human experience. Feel it. You have to feel it to heal it. Do you agree, Ator? Nah, he seems to agree. Keep your hand on your heart if you wish. I'm going to keep mine. here because it's helping me connect with my experience 3.5 years ago. The wailing, the crying, the pain. This is time in the universe metamorphosing you, metamorphosizing, putting you through the metamorphosis to become the next best, stronger version of yourself. This is incredible. Be grateful that you had the courage to love. It's never a bad idea to love. Pure giving love is the most amazing thing on this earth. And you gave that to someone. You gave that to someone. That's amazing. That's amazing. And you cannot control, you do not own another person. Pure love is loving in such a way that other people are free, completely free. I'm a father of two daughters. I'm a father of two daughters. When I look at how to love someone, I have learned that how I love them is pure love. Sienna, my 7-year-old, I told her yesterday, Sienna, got a surprise for you. We hadn't come back to my condo here yet, but I hadn't gotten my kids yet, and I picked up a little surprise, a package of chocolate chip cookie dough. I said, Sienna, I have this surprise for you, but I'm not going to tell you what it is until we get to my condo. She says, a surprise? Really? Really, Sienna, surprise. Wow. She's super excited. Her eyes light up. A few hours later, get back to my condo. Girls come in, get their stuff in the rooms. I take them into the kitchen. I say, girls, close your eyes. I have a surprise. I open the refrigerator, take out the package of chocolate chip cookie dough, hold it in front of my daughters, and I show it to them and I say, open your eyes. Sienna, my 7-year-old, looks at it and goes, ugh! Storms off into her room. As her father, she did that. And my response wasn't, what's your problem, Sienna? Why are you being that way? It was, aw, Sienna, come here, sweetie. Come give me a hug. The love I have for my daughters, that's pure and unconditional. Sienna could kick me, punch me, curse me. And all I feel is warmth and love to her. I'm so fortunate to be a parent because I have this reference now. There's just something in the DNA with my children in the way that I love them. And that doesn't always get applied to other people. Someone else may storm off or do something. He's back. or my cat. My cat, the same way. Learning to love others that way, this person that broke your heart, that you feel so devastated about. How would you love a child? Love this person the same way. Certainly don't accept things that could be super harmful to you, of course, or any kind of bad treatment, of course. But most of the time, the heartbreak I've seen is because one person did not do what another expected. And if you look at children and parents and unconditional love, no parent that truly loves their child can be heartbroken by their child. That's powerful. That's so powerful. And I get it. We all have our egos and view of ourselves. Who wants to feel like they weren't worth someone's love and time and attention because that person left or stopped loving them? But go back to children. And the love, especially if you have children, the love toward children is the answer. It's the key. And heartbreak is a good thing because, one, you have felt and loved. And you have an opportunity to take this experience, and as you move forward toward the future, to love like a parent. To love like a parent. Or love like a brother. Or love like a sister. And when you love like that, you cannot get heartbroken. So that becomes the next test for you in your life. Can you love like a father, a mother, a brother, or a sister for the next person that comes along? When you love like that, you become something more. You become something more. And people feel that. They feel your energy. They trust you more. They feel more comfortable around you. It's not easy to do. Especially when your emotions are heightened and your heart is beating fast and you feel the intensity of the experience. Feel it to heal it. Talk to your friends. Go to the gym, work out. Move your body. Cry, roll on the floor, kick, scream, yell. Hit your pillow. All those things. To allow it to flow out of your body. And then on the other side, one day you're going to wake up and you're going to say, I just slept through the night and I feel pretty good right now. And as it seems to be the case every time, after the period of heartbreak, you'll be back to where you were before the heartbreak with new knowledge, tools, and experiences to apply to the future. That's personal growth and evolution. right there. Heartbreak is so good for you. It's a good thing. It means you're out there. It means you're out there being courageous and brave and experiencing this thing called life. And good for you. Good for you. You will have a new you to navigate the next future experience. Heartbreak is a good thing for you. Remember that. You're going to be just fine. Namaste. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.